The year of the Quiet Ocean 2020, and this refers specifically to the effect the noise of the human activities have in the oceans and in the marine organisms. However, I think it is the right floor today to try to see this in a wider aspect, because the noise is not only the maritime activities or the fisheries activities to the marine organisms, but it is an holistic, let's say, point of the anthropogenic activities which affect and have a noise in a wider approach on the marine organisms. So everybody agrees that ocean health is our health, because actually the ocean touches nearly every aspect of our lives, provides food, recreational opportunities, shoreline protection, job opportunities, and so on. And going to the two basic issues referred here in our today talk. First is, what is the impact of human noise to the oceans? We have already some metrics. There is a problem, and here we can see that from 50 to 74 of vertebrate population, there is a decline. And this is more particular concerning fish stocks. And if we go to this slide, we see that there is a number of threatened marine species. Okay, we can see that there with the red in the columns in the right, we have a number of species which are threatened, from dolphins and whales to invertebrates like sponges and mollusks. And if we go to particular habitats, we see that we have already a negative effect on the marine environment. We have a 50% trophical reefs which have been lost over the last 30 years. And a similar situation is also when we consider seagrasses habitats. If we go to see which are the threats which are affecting the marine environment and the marine biodiversity I referred earlier, first of all is habitat loss and degradation. I will pass very quickly. The second threat is overexploitation of fish stocks, either directly, because we have, let's say, an overexploitation of commercial fish species, but we do have also an indirect result from overexploitation of fish stocks, because we have species which are caught by fisheries bycatch. It's not a target, like sea turtles, like dolphins, which is not target, but however, they are affected by fisheries activity. And then we have ghost fishing, abandoned fishing tools in the marine environment, which are creating a problem to marine biodiversity. Pollution is definitely one of the major threats in different ways. We have land-based sources of pollution, we have marine, sea-based sources, and you can see certain of this in this slide. And going further away, we have the biggest problem the last decades, which is marine debris. We have the macroplastics, different material coming to the sea by human activities. And of course, we have a serious problem, because marine debris and especially microplastics go to the food chain and create a problem to the organisms and us. Climate change is another threat. I will very quickly pass. Ultraviolet radiation and intensification of extreme events is something which also has a contribution to climate change effects. And invasive species, something which is clearly connected with increase of sea temperature. We see here in the graph up on the right the exponential increase in invasive species in all the seas of the world. And of course, aquaculture, which has covered, as you can see, almost 60% of the fish food, and aquaculture in certain areas is creating a problem. And of course, tourism is another action which makes a problem for the marine environment. However, the most important of all is this last slide on the threats, which is the cumulative impacts. It's not only one activity which creates the problem, but it is all the different activities I mentioned earlier, which are gathered in order to create a problem. And here is the example of the Mediterranean. You see different threats and different activities of human being. And here we can see that there are certain areas in the Mediterranean basin which have strongly been affected by the different anthropogenic activities. So let's go to the second part, which is what can we expect from now on as to the ocean's health? And one critical, I would say, key, if we want to be resolutive and have a positive effect concerning ocean's health, is marine protected areas. Areas which are designated in order to protect the habitat loss, the species loss, and also sustainability. Of course, there are different kinds of marine protected areas, the most important one being the marine reserves, the areas we have no take zones, so only swimming, boating, scuba diving, eco-friendly activities are taking place, and nothing else. And as I said, and we can see also in this slide, marine protected areas are smart investments in ocean health, and this is widely recognized. And I should emphasize it, that the role of MPAs is not only dealing with protection of the environment, but also contribute and significantly also in issues having economic development and tourism. Specific specific activities in tourism. Where are we? And I'm finished in a couple of minutes. There was a goal to have 10% of the oceans covered with MPAs. However, as you can see in this slide, we have not achieved this goal. We have only 7.7% of the oceans covered with MPAs. And you can see areas of the world where we do have, let's say, the majority of MPAs. And our next goal is to, this is reported in the 2030 agenda, to have, as you can see there, from 7.7 nowadays to reach 30% in 2030. I'm not so optimistic about that, especially if we see what it was our previous goal. But finishing my presentation, I would like to stay a little bit more in the Mediterranean, where the situation is far away of being, let's say, having this goal I mentioned earlier a little bit, really questionable if we can manage to do that. Because if we see the numbers, we see where we are today, 7.14, but only the stronger protection marine reserves is covering, as you see, less than 0.1. And having in mind the Mediterranean is an area, is a basin where we do have a lot of anthropogenic activities, really makes questionable if we are going to achieve this goal.